What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com because I signed myself. Now, I got a question for you. Are you attracting bad fans? How could that even be a thing, bad fans? What do bad fans even look like? Well, here's an example. I heard a lot of people commenting on a video I did about an artist by the name of Justin Snow, right? And Justin has an intriguing brand. People think, oh man, this guy just does shock value. It's a lot more than shock value. There's a lot more substance and attention to detail than just service level shock value. But you know, you can let those people have that opinion. But what's interesting, right, and what people have to think about is because of the nature of his brand, right, because it's something that might get looked at as a little harsh, right, or a little gory, and maybe, you know, anti-feminist, right, or anti-women, however you want to look at it, it does attract, in some ways, certain types of people, right? Some people that might just be weirdos, let's put it that way. Like, some people that might just be weirdos. You have people that aren't that. There's a huge, you know, level of the fan base that wouldn't be that. But you also will be attracting a certain type of people just because of the images you put out. And that's where we get back to attracting bad fans. What I mean by that is, from my promotion days, my days going heavy, 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 particularly with events, I started to notice the power of the imagery, the feel, the energy that you put into your marketing. Like, okay, if I want this thing to be a twerk fest, then I need to show images of twerking. I need to use words like twerk fest. I need to have a flyer with, you know, water splashing everywhere and the girls looking that way. If I want this to be all about fun and adventure, then I need to show things about people having fun and looking like they're having togetherness, or it's just random and colorful, things like that. You know, putting the energy out into your marketing, right, that you want people to bring to your event. And that's the same thing that it goes for an artist. I remember I went to Aminé's event, and when Aminé had a concert, I was at the front in the VIP area, and then I remember turning around, having my camera and looking at everybody. I'm like, yo, this crowd is having so much fun together. And that's a different type of fan base. It's been a while since I've been to an environment like that where the fan base was literally, it was all this good energy, right? And not even just that hype, because Travis Scott shows, right, they have a lot of good energy, but it could go left. But no, it was just literally just like pure joy and fun. But if you think about the music that the guy puts out and the brand, what it looks and feels like, those are the type of people that it attracts. I remember doing videos on YouTube. I had this one concept that got taken down, and it was attracting some dudes, like some anti-Semites, just like a whole bunch of interesting, weird people. It was attracting, you know, regular people, but it was attracting weird people. So it's just remembering what you put out will actually attract the type of fans that you want. And this is to a literal standpoint. I know a lot of times it's conceptual. What type of people do you want to reach out to? But if you look at the people who get attracted by the content that you put out, it should give you an idea of what you're putting out, because at the end of the day, I know we experiment sometimes, but just as a core, you should understand what you're doing to the extent of, like, what type of person would be interested in this, right? Or if you're just projecting yourself, hopefully you're attracting people that you would like as well. But also remember that it's more than just pictures, right? Of course, you can have a dark, gloomy vibe. Of course, you can show like beautiful women and show cars to say we love luxury and things like that. But on a whole nother level, you also have to understand just the messaging of the words that you use, right? Do I say twerk fest, or do I say gala, or do I say ball, or do I say kickback? Like, all those words have a different connotation to people. And far bigger than just a still picture itself is a video. And that's one of the most powerful things that you will get when it comes to marketing. If you have videos of being inside a performance, and you can stage these things, it happens all the time. Like, if you stage just a sense of a performance and make it feel good and have a full energy outside of just, oh, we jumping on the stage heavy. No, like, make it seem crowd interactive or whatever the energy that you want. If you stage that on a small scale or just execute it really well with a crowd of 20 people, but it's a tight environment, then make sure you capture that to the fullest. You can literally position the environment and get it from different angles and make it feel like way more than 20 people, which is irrelevant. Just stage it just like a music video, just to feel how you want it to feel. And when you market that, it'll make people be more likely to even want to come to your shows. But even more important, it'll make them want to bring the energy to your show that you projected in your video, in your visuals. And once that happens, your show has a far better chance of being successful. That's it. Once again, this video is brought to you by BrandManNetwork.com. And if you like this video, go ahead and like button. If you like it, might as well share. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.